वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृत वंदे भगवंतं पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तुमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणिजातिपूर्वम् एतादृश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तरुमहदेवमात्मविद्युत्प्रकाशमनुष्यं शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्गणेशाय नमो वयं सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परम् तदेवाहन्नमत्वं मे निश्चितामतिः निर्गुण उपासना सगुण उपासना बोथ आर डिस्कस्ड हियर विथ प्रणव एज टॉट बाय श्रुति. सो निर्गुण प्रणव उपासना क्रम प्रणव बीइंग ओंकार विच इज दी नाम ऑफ ब्रह्म बोथ सगुण एंड निर्गुण एंड बेस्ड ऑन वेदर वन वॉन्ट्स टू गो टू ब्रह्मलोक और वन wants mukti here and now jivan mukti. Both goals are served by dhyana, but we have to understand kramena. In the case of jivan mukti, kramena jnanotpatti dwara. And how jnanotpatti can take place? So there the question was answered, how jnanotpatti can take place is, I think here somewhere we saw that, how, so that aham brahma asmi, ज्ञान क्रमेण ज्ञानत्व द्वारा मोक्ष सिद्ध्यति. वी सॉ इन द टिप्पण एज टू हाउ दैट इज पॉसिबल. द एग्जाम्पल गिवन वॉज दिस संवादी भ्रांति. सो इवन इफ देर इज अ भ्रांति इफ वन डज नॉट नो इन द केस ऑफ लेट से द मणि समथिंग विच शाइन्स इज अ मणि और इट कैन बी अ लैम्प ऑल्सो. नाउ इफ वन कंसिडर इज अ लैम्प एंड गोज देयर ही विल ऑल्सो गेट द मणि. One considers it as a money and goes there, he'll also get the money. So, jnana of the money will lead to money labha, and that is possible even by bhranti. So, I gave a lot of roundabout way. So, let me just explain it in a very simple manner. The person who is looking at a room where there is a money, he does not know that there is a money. It shines forth like a lamp or like a money. Now, a person who considers it as a money will also get the money, and one who considers it as a lamp, but just let me go and have a look. The person who misunderstood it as a lamp also will get the money. So, the bhranti of the money is seeing the lamp instead of taking it as money itself. We'll see take a person who sees it as a lamp, but still approaches it and gets money. So he is perceiving money as a lamp, as a deepa, was a bhranti. But did it not lead to mani jnana on approaching it, and did it not lead to mani labha? So that is explained here as samvadi bhrantya dhavata pumsapi. Mani jnana dwara mani labhavat. So just like that, here also, if one does the prakrita ahangraha dhyana, even if one does not know it, still, even if one considers that I am an individual and does the dhyana of aham brahmasmi, it will lead to brahma jnana because shravana has taken place. That is the important point that we have to notice. Shravana has already taken place, which hasn't worked earlier, which might start working, there is a possibility. So moving on with the Nirguna Pranav Upasana. Nirguna प्रणव उपासना हियर या सर्व निर्गुण प्रणव उपासना क्रम इन डिटेल सर्व सर्व तू टाइपो
Sarva Vastu Naam Omkara Upasana.
Vastu Naam, right? It should be Vastu Naam. So, is there in the errata, right?
No, it is in the other book.
Okay, okay. Yeah, okay. You have to print another book. Okay, so Sarva Vastu Naam, let's go with that. So, Sarva Vastu Naam, Sarva Vastu Naam Omkara Swarupatvam. So, all Vastus are Omkara. I had explained that in brief. Last time, how Mandukya deals with it. So the basis it, we'll go through this, but then just let me bring in a refresher. Pada and Padarthas have Abheda. So Pada Padarthayo Abheda. How every Padartha is nothing but Pada. Vacharambana Vikaro Nama Dhyam, says this Chandogya Shruti. Now every Nama is included, every pada is included in Omkara, Akaroi Sarvavak. That Shruti says that. And we know that every word is included in the alphabet, in any language. And here, Akara, Ukara, Makara represents the triad of, in Mandukya, it represents even the Vishwa, Taijas and Prajna. And in the Srishta Prapancha, with Nama, represents all namas because akara is when you open the mouth, makara is when you close the mouth. Ukara covers the entire range of all the letters between akara and makara, meaning between the akara is the first vowel, which is the first utterance when anyone opens the mouth. Even as a child who does not know how to speak, as soon as the child opens the mouth, there is akara utterance. And closing has to be makara because the lips are going to come together. Ukara covers all the other vowels and consonants. Thereby, Om covers all words and all words, all padas are representative of the padarthas. You cannot have padartha jnana without the pada. So, pada padartha abheda and all padas are included in Omkara. That is the basis for this nirguna prana upasana in any upasana. Krama where Omkara is used. So Vastu Naam Omkara Swarupatvam Nirguna Prana Upasana Kramaha Eva Atra Nirupyate Na Saguna Upasana Kramaha. Saguna Upasana Krama is more detailed and needs a different kind of approach leading to what? Basically leading to Brahma Loka. That is not the goal of Vedanta Shastra proper. So here that is the reason it is not included. Second reason is because, you know, every other goal is included in the person attaining Nirguna Brahma as oneself. So Nirguna includes Saguna in that sense by including the Phala. Thereby, Saguna Upasanasya Phalam Api Nirguna Upasane Antara Bhavati. As though, because one is Kritakritya, and one is Kritakritya is Sarva Karma Krit does not need to do Saguna Upasana because that also is included by Phala being included, Ananda Rupa Phala being included. Tathahi Nirguna Upasatasya Brahma Loke Ichhavataha Ichha Rupa Pratibandha Sattvat Na Jnana Dwara Moksha Labha. Now one who is doing this Nirguna Upasana, but while doing Nirguna Upasana, there is a Brahma Loka Ichha as well. Then this person will not get jnana because any ichha is a badaka. Finally, the moksha ichha also has to be dropped off. The last to be dropped off, but still it has to be dropped off. Why? Because moksha ichha means that I am giving reality to the individuality, which is not true. The individuality itself is a bhranti. So to say that I get the Aham Brahmasmi Jnana, but I am not Mukta because I feel the individuality is basically being completely immersed in avidya, still, even after the Jnanotpatti, denying that Jnana, saying that, no, I am still an individual. At whatever level of subtlety, even if that individuality remains at whatever level of subtlety, still one is denying that Aikya Jnana, one is not accepting it completely in toto, but has some obstacles which can be in the form of Brahmaloka Icha also. Because there is Bhoga Icha. Any Bhoga Icha, Brahmaloka Icha is can be seen to be the highest Bhoga. And also Shuddha because it's Shastriya and it is leading to Moksha. Even that, so you can take Prathama Malla Nyaya also, even that Icha is going to be a Badaka. And we can go one step further and say that even the Moksha Icha, after being a Jijnyasu, after being a Jnani, Moksha Icha lingering on will bind the person. Tathahi Nirgunopasa Tasya Brahmaloka Icha Vataha Tasya. One who is an Ichhavan, Brahmaloka Ichhavan, Tasya, Ichharupa Pratibandha Sattvat. Because there is obstacle in the form of that Ichha, Brahmaloka Ichha being. Jnana Dwara Na Moksha Labha. So Na is written here. Moksha Labha Na Bhavati. Jnana Dwara. So Jnana Dwara, because Jnana is already there. And if it isn't there, if it is not Dridha yet, it will not become Dridha because Brahmaloka Ichha is going to hijack the person's mind. Kintu tasya brahmaloka praptir bhavati. That person will get brahmaloka. Even if he is a sadhaka, he'll get brahmaloka. Satatra hiranyagarbha saman. Tatra brahmaloke. Hiranyagarbha saman bhogan anuhuya. Tatra eva brahmavicharana jnanodvaya dvara mokshan labhate. So there jnanodvaya will take place in brahmaloka. Brahmavichara is needed, manana is also needed. And the acharya there is Swayam Chaturmukha Brahma. So one cannot miss it. It is very difficult to miss, you know. Those who cook, so they know that the easiest thing to cook in, say, want to make some sabji, the easiest thing is making potato sabji. You cannot spoil it. I mean, you have to really be an expert. Such an expert in spoiling everything that you can spoil the potato sabji also. Not much to do. Similarly, here you cannot miss it. The contrast is like Prakash and Tamaha. One cannot confuse, have a confusion between the two. That kind of clarity is there in Brahmaloka. So unless one is having some other Icha there, so just like Brahmaloka Prapti Icha here, Brahmaloka Icha Vataha Atra. But tatra, Brahmaloke, if somebody is carrying other ichchas, then jnana will not enter. That is the only possibility that one would be denied the knowledge in Brahmaloka also, because it is so easy, should be so easy. And once one reaches Brahmaloka, this Hiranyagarbha Saman Bhogan Anubhuya, these bhogas can be a deterrent there in Brahmaloka, that will bring in more and more vasanas and one may remain trapped in those pleasures, in those anubhavas and thereby miss the jnana. So that is hinted here, tatraya brahma vicharana jnanadvaya dvara mokshan labhate. Or it can be because this upasaka has done the upasana, the phala is the bhoga anubhava, which is equivalent to Hiranyagarbha's Ananda Anubhava, because Hiranyagarbha Anubhava is the highest Anubhava. Even in the Taittiriya Ananda Mimamsa, you see Hiranyagarbha Ananda is the highest. There cannot be anything superior because Hiranyagarbha is a Sukshma Sharira, Samashti Sukshma Sharira Abhimani. All the Ananda is manifest in the Sukshma Shariras. All the Anandas, sum total of all the Anandas is experienced by Hiranyagarbha, but not the Dukkha. Dukkha Anubhava isn't there, Sukha Anubhava is there. Thereby one gets similar Sukha. That is what is mentioned here. Brahmaloka Ichcharaitasya निर्गुणोपासकस्य तु इह एव लोके ज्ञानलाभान् मोक्षः सिद्ध्यति. बट फॉर दी अदर हु इज अ रियल मुमुक्षु हु वांट्स जीवन मुक्ति हियर एंड नाउ गेट्स इट हियर एंड नाउ बिकॉज देयर इज नो अदर इच्छा विच इज ब्लॉकिंग हिज ज्ञानोत्पत्ति एंड निष्ठा. फाइनली निष्ठा शुड बी देयर. दैट इज इन ब्लॉक बिकॉज इफ वन इज डूइंग ध्यान दैट टाइम every other thought comes except for the jhaya vastu, and then slowly a person trains one's mind, weans it away from the vishayas, from all the ichha vishayas, whether gross or subtle, and then takes towards the jhaya vastu. This is the natural krama, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. But a person who has ichha even of brahmaloka will, at a subtle level, it will keep one away from, so one step away, had that person dropped that ichha, one would have got moksha here and now. But for this person who has no brahmaloka ichha also, that kind of a nirguna upasaka will get the jnana. Jnana utpatti will take place due to the purva shravana which has done. Itham saguna upasana phalasya nirguna upasana antarbhuta vaad iha nirguna upasana meva nirupyate. Because prapti brahmaloka prapti is also for ananda. And Jivan Mukti Ananda supersedes that, and or even if it doesn't supersede, we can say in the Anubhava it may be same as the Brahmaloka Ananda Anubhava, thereby the phala is antargata here and now. Therefore Jivan Mukti being the goal, even reaching Brahmaloka, the goal still remains one step ahead as Jivan Mukti. There of course Krama Mukti, therefore Kalpante there will be Mukti. Here it will be at the very moment of jnana nishtha. Karana kare rupam sarvam vastu omkara sarupam eva. Now that is explained as to how the karana and karya, all of these, because sarvam, the topic is what? Sarva vastu nam omkara sarupattam. How are all vastus omkara? That is explained here as atas sarvo api rupa prapanchaha omkara eva. Karana karya rupam sarvam vastu omkara sarupam eva. This can also be seen as, because it is manifest from Omkara, Omkara being the name for Ishvara. So everything is pervaded by Ishvara, be it Karana or Karya, and thereby Sarva Api Rupa Prapanchaha. Manifest world is all Omkara Eva. Sarveshu Api Padarteshu Nama Rupam Cha Iti Aumsha Dvayam Asti. There is Nama and Rupa. Every Padartha has Nama and Rupa. Rupa is what? Padartha really. Nama is Pada. So if you look at it, sarveshu api padarteshu nama and rupam cha iti aumshadvayamasti. There are two aumshas. Tatra rupatmakaha aumshaha tattan namatmaka aumshaha na tirichyate. The rupa padartha is never separate from nama pada. Kintu nama swarupam eva rupamsho api bhavati. तथा ही पदार्थानां रूपात्मको यः आकार विशेष तद अभिधायक नाम पदैरेव सर्वे पदार्थाः निरूपिताः सन्तः गृह्यन्ते त्यज्यन्ते वा. हौ सो सो किन्तु नाम स्वरूपमेव रूपांश अपि. हौ इज पदार्थ पद, हौ इज रूप सेम एज नाम. एंड दिस इज व्हाट इज सेड अबाउट ईश्वर. व्हेन यू डू जपा ऑल्सो देर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन नाम एंड नामनी. Nama Namni has no bheda at all. When you say Harihi, Rama, it means that Rama, same Rama. So the name, when you are calling out a name, you are calling Ishvara. How, in any case, when you call out or talk about some name, Devadatta did this. Which Devadatta? Devadatta, you are just using a name. But how is the Padartha, that Devadatta entity name? By using Devadatta as a tag, as a name, as a handle for Vyavahara. But what you really want to talk about is that when you say Devadatta, Devadatta Gacchati, Devadatta Himalayam Gacchati, then that Himalayam Gacchati, Kaha Gacchati, that Devadatta who is the entity, Padartha, not Pada. So Pada Padartha or Abheda, when you call Hari, why does Hari respond? बिकॉज पद पदार्थ और अभेद तथा ही पदार्थ नाम रूपात्मक यह आकार विशेष Rupa is seen as akara. Padartha is known through akara because we cognize through our sense organs, especially the chakshurindriya. Tad abhidhayaka nama padaihi eva sarve padartha nirupitaha santa griyante tejyante va. Without the name you cannot transact. So when you want to pick up something, you want to use that name. Even if you don't utter it, it is there in your antakarana. There is nama vritti taking place, which is none other than the padartha vritti. Padavritti is not different from padartha vritti there. As soon as it padavritti takes place, what comes to mind is the padartha. There is no real padavritti separate from the padartha vritti. Because some word you don't know, you know, Puja Swami used to utter some word, Google or something like that, and he would say, what did you understand? You understood nothing. Why? Because pada is meaningless. Pada padartha sambandha is nitya. Only when that pada carries meaning, then only it will make sense. Otherwise, just pada gives you nothing. You can utter something, but it is meaningless. The set of letters have to be meaningful. The nama is always representing the vastu. The rupa is represented by the nama. Therefore, there is no difference between nama and rupa. Rupa is nama swarupa. Rupaamsha as nama swarupa. Tattad abhidhana jnanam antara kevala akara matrena vyavaharam siddhyati. Now you take the flip side also. Let's say there is an akara. You can't just keep on looking at the akara and transact. There has to be nama. In the vritti also there has to be nama. Ataha nama eva sarabhutam. Therefore, the essence of rupa is also nama. And that is why the Shruti says, vacharambhana vikaru namadhyam. And arambha there is alambhana. Begin with a name. So, vacharambhana. But there is vak. Arambha and then not arambha, that arambha is alambhanam yasya. Yasya prapanchasya, yasya padarthasya. Vikaro nama dhyam. So it is, dhyaya is like matra. So nama matra, that's what it is. This nama dhyaya, this padartha is all nothing but what? Sarvam, vacharanam vikara, all vikaraha, vikaras are karyas. In the Chandogya Upanishad, when you look at it, karya karana, prakriya is being taught. So every mrunmaya jagat is all nothing but mrut. Every suvarna ve prapancha is suvarna. Karya karana, indifference, abheda is being taught. So karana is nothing, karya is nothing but karana. Now, as the Shruti moves further in another section, because the question is there, Shishya is keeping the questions intact. But they are changing. There are questions, but then he is maturing towards the goal. So there are this Tattvamasi Upadesha has been done 9 times in these 6 chapter. So Shvetaketu keeps on asking, you know, give me another example so that I understand it better. So even in the same prakriya, there is some sub-prakriya by which, using the example of a river, how the river is not different from the samudra. How the rivers are not different, how the water, for every river there is nama bheda, but they are nothing but water. So all these examples are used. How the vriksha, the parts of vrikshas, how they survive and how they do not survive. When, you know, it's hit, how they keep on shedding. So Videya Mukti also is taught there, using examples. How, you know, putting the salt in water, how salt mixes up in such a manner that you cannot differentiate. So that kind of aikya is there. How the ashwata vriksha is there in a very tiny, minuscule
seed.
Very easy to miss that kind of a seed, such a small seed, but has the entire ashwata vriksha within. So karya is completely included in the bija rupa karana. Similarly, here rupa is not different from nama because moving ahead it says vacharambhanam vikaro namadhyam. All vikaras or karyas are nothing but vak. They have vak as alambana. Therefore, each of these padartha cognition is begun with vak. So, has an arambha in vak by vak being the alambana. That is how the Shruti explains it. Therefore, rupa is not different from nama, and akara cannot be the basis for any transaction there. So, tattad abhidhana jnanam antara kevala akara matrana vyavaharana siddhyati, one should have padajnana, ataha nama eva sarabhutam. That nama is the essence of all rupas, all padarthas. Akara nashe api nama avashishyate. What is more pervasive? That is the satya. Karana pervades the karya. When there is akara nasha, still nama remains. Let's say you have ghata at home, that ghata is broken. Ghata nasha has taken place. Satta is still there in the ghata karana. But another way to look at it is, ghata nama, does it still make sense? Because you have ghata vritti within. Ghata outside is broken, but ghata vritti in your mind, which is a padartha vritti, does it remain? It remains because the ghata pada keeps it alive. Satta is there in the ghata pada. That is another way to look at it. Not in the karana, there in the... It's a very nice prakriya. It's easy to see the gross karya being created out of a gross karana. But if you look at the gross karya being created out of a subtle karana, is difficult. But if you look at this example, nama avashishyate akara nashe api. So, padartha nashe api padam avashishyate. Thereby you see that it is nothing but pada there. Yatha nashte api ghate mrud avashishyate iti mrudvyatirekena ghato nasti kintu mrutsarupam eva bhavati. This is an easily known example we have seen so many times across everything. You know, this is a bread and butter example for Vedantin. Tatha akara nashte api. But understand this in the case of the akara, which continues to be there in the nama. Tatha akara nashte api mrudvad avashishyam mana namnah na vidyate. Akara. So akara is never separate from nama, meaning padartha is never separate from pada, meaning rupa is never separate from nama. Kintu nama swarupam eva bhavati akara api, meaning sarva prapancha api nama swarupam eva bhavati, and nama is what all is included in omkara. Athava, another way to look at it, ghata shara ghata शरावोदनादि. सो घट शरावोदनादिषु मृदनुगता भवति. ऑल ऑफ दीज वेदर यू टेक घट कुंभ और दी यू नो दी लिड वॉट एवर यू टेक दीज आर ऑल नथिंग बट मृत. दिस इज अ प्रक्रिया वी नो कार्य इज नेवर सेपरेट फ्रॉम कारण. घट शराव हैव अ लिटिल ट्रबल pronouncing this, so ghata shara vodananchanadayaha parasparam vyabhicharanti. Between the karyas, individual karyas, there is bheda, but between individual karyas and the karana, there is no bheda. So ghata has a difference with kumbha ityadi, but ghata is not different from mrut. Kumbha is also not different from mrut. But still, between them there can be a difference. So just because you see difference between two rupas, between two padarthas, which are created from the same karana, so between two karyas, if there is a difference, but they still are not different from their karanas individually. So when they manifest with difference manifests, but then in the karana there cannot be any difference. Similarly, in nama there cannot be a difference. When you say a big ghata or a small ghata, you are looking at it. Rupa wise, you can make out a difference, ghata 1 and ghata 2. But both are ghatas. So, nama bheda isn't there. There can be rupa bheda. Between the rupas, there is, between the two ghata rupas, there is bheda. But between the ghata 1 and the vrut as karana, and also ghata as nama, there is no difference. And ghata as, ghata 2 as karya, and mruda as karana, there is no difference. And ghata 2 as, ghata 2 because only to differentiate, ghata 2 is not a name, ghata is the name. And there is no difference, but there is no difference between ghata 2, which is seen as a second ghata, but has only mruda as karana, or ghata as nama as its karana. There is no difference between the two. तस्माद् घटशरवादयः मिथ्या तेषु अनुगता मृत् सत्या मृत् सत्य एवं घटस्य आकारः नाना तेषां अभिधायकं घट इति नाम एकमेव ऑल्दो घटस्य आकारः नाना मृत् इज वन क्ले इज वन बट द घटाज आर मेनी घट आकाराज आर मेनी घट दट पदा घट इज ऑल्सो वन जस्ट लाइक मृत् इज वन घट इज ऑल्सो वन एकस्य घटस्य आकारो न घटांतरे अस्ति बिटवीन द टू घटास द रूपास हैव वेरिएशंस बट द पदा घटा इज यूज्ड घटा इज वन द पदा घटा पदा घटा नाम इज वन दैट डज नॉट हैव एनी व्यभिचार रूप हैज व्यभिचार नाम डज नॉट हैव व्यभिचार दिस इज अनदर वे टू लुक एट तस्मात् आकार व्यभिचारिणः सर्वेषु अपि घटाकारेषु एकमेव नाम अनुगतं वर्तते तस्मात् मिथ्याभूत आकार सत्यभूता नामनः न अतिरिच्यते सो वॉट एवर हैज व्यभिचार इज मिथ्या आकार इज मिथ्या बिकॉज आकार हैज व्यभिचार अक्रॉस कार्य यू सी आकार हैज व्यभिचार सो घटा एंड अन्य घटा हैव डिफरेंस इन रूप बट इन नाम देयर इज नो व्यभिचार तस्मात् मिथ्याभूत आकार सत्यभूत नामनः न अतिरिच्यते आकार इज मिथ्या नाम इज सत्य एंड आकार डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट सेपरेट फ्रॉम नाम रियली इत्थमेव सर्वपदार्थानां आकारः अपि तत्तन्नामनः न व्यतिरिक्तः तस्मात् नामस्वरूप एव आकार सो देयर आर टू वेज टू लुक एट हाउ पदार्थ इज नॉट सेपरेट फ्रॉम पदा और रूप इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम नाम सर्व अयम नाम प्रपंच ओंकार व्यतिरेकेण नास्ति बट अवर उपासना इज प्रणव उपासना वेर हैव वी लैंडेड ऑन ओंकार वी हैव लैंडेड ऑन नाम प्रपंच सो इन रिजॉल्विंग चिंतन प्रकार इज सच दैट यू डू लय चिंतन अर्लियर लय चिंतन वॉज मेन्शन इट इज इन द सृष्टि क्रम opposite to the Srishti Krama. It is in the reverse of the Srishti Krama. Now here, Nama also is before understanding the Rupa. Pada precedes this Padartha and now you do the reverse. Here, Omkara represents all Nama. Therefore, now from all Namas, you can land on the Omkara as the basis, which is Akshara Brahma. तो सर्वोऽयं नाम प्रपंचः ओंकार व्यतिरेकेण नास्ति किन्तु ओंकार स्वरूपमेव सर्वं नाम हौ सो तथा हि वाचक शब्द एव नाम इति कथ्यते व्हाटएवर इज गोइंग टू रिवील द पदार्थ दैट इज कॉल्ड एज नाम लोके वेदे च प्रयुक्तः सर्वः शब्द ओंकार एव उत्पन्न इति श्रुतिः श्रुतिषु उच्यते इन श्रुति इट इज सेड ओंकार इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एवरीथिंग So where is it? Tadyatha shankuna sarvani parnani santrushnani evam omkarena sarva vak santrunna omkare vidam sarvam iti So Chandogya Upanishad mentions this. Tadyatha shankuna sarvani parnani santrushnani Example is given. Evam omkarena sarva vak santrunna If you pick up a leaf. So leaf, if you pick up this ashwatta leaf, you look at it, you see You know, I don't know how many of us have done it as a child. As children, you pick up a leaf and then it becomes a bookmark. You know, old school. And it is not just a bookmark or per se, there is a play involved. So the leaf is green, but it starts drying up. And when you kept inside the book, after, you know, few days or weeks or whatever, you open the book, you'll see the green leaf has become brown, and then suddenly, you know, it has become brittle. And the you know, the veins come up. You can, just the veins are seen. The leaf is so dry that, you know, it is brittle. It may not happen in a few weeks, but across a long time, the only, you can see only the veins there. Even before you can see the veins, but the more it dries, the more the veins are visible, where all it is reaching. So that is the example here. Shanku is that the vein inside the leaf, how it pervades, you know, all these. So by the Shanku, how all the leaves are pervaded. Similarly, by Omkara, every Nama Rupa, so Sarva Vak, all names are pervaded. So this is Sarva Vak, this, all this is Ekavachana, you can say Jato Ekavachanam. Omkara Evaidam Sarvam, that is another Shruti, so it is very clear there, Omkara, everything is nothing but Omkara Iti. Karyam Sarvam Karna Swarupam Eva Bhavati, Tasmad Omkara Kari Bhutani, Vachaka Shabdatmakani, Namani, Omkara Swarupani. Karya is never separate from Karana, and all the Namas are nothing but made up of letters, Aksharas. All these Aksharas are included in the Omkara, therefore, Omkara is Karana, everything is Karya, and Karya, everything is not different from Omkara. So, Vachaka Shabda Atmaka Namas are never different, are Karyas, and they are not separate from Omkara. They are Omkara Swarupa. Itham Rupamsho Yah Padarthakaraha Sa Nama Swarupaha Nama Cha Sarva Omkara Swarupam Tasmat Sarva Swarupa Omkara. So, in closing, to summarize, all Padarthas are Padas themselves, they are not separate from Padas, and Padas are all Antargata in Omkara, therefore everything in the Prapancha is Omkara Swarupa. Omkara Yatha. So let's look at the Tippana. I missed it where it was. Anyway, Yatha Punya Rikyat Manushya Apekshaya Adhika Kalasthayi Devaha Amara Iti Upacharai उपचारेण उच्यते तथा एव घटादि पदार्थ पदार्थानां आकारापेक्षया घटादीनाम्ना अधिक कालस्थायित्वात् नामनाम सत्यत्वं उपचारात् उच्यते. सो नाम हैज बीन सेड एज सत्य हियर. सो नाम सत्य हियर, सॉरी. सो सत्यभूत नामनः आकारः न अतिरिच्यते. Akara is Mithya, Nama is Satya. But this Satyatvam is relative. It is Apekshika Satyatvam. It is not Satyatvam the way it is Trikala Abadita Satyatvam. Nama is also Badita. So Nama is Sat only in comparison with Akara. So if you look at Akara and Nama, yes, Akara is Mithya. Is Nama Mithya? Yes, Nama is also Mithya. But in comparison to Akara, Karya is Mithya, Karana is Satya. Just because you are saying that Mrit is Satya, Ghata is Mithya, does not mean that Mrit is Satya. If you analyze Mrit, is Mrit Karya or Karana? It is Karana, all right, but it is Karya as well. Therefore, it will also be seen as, it also has to be seen as Mithya. So when you are looking at the reference point, based on that, the Mithyatvam and Satyatvam, these will carry a different meaning. So from the reference point of Ghata, Ghata is Mithya. From the reference point of Mrit, Ghata is Mithya. And Mrit is Satya. But Mrit itself is Mithya if you go to Mrit Karana. When you analyze Mrit, then that time Mrit will not remain Satya. Similarly here, Nama is Satya when you are taking the analysis as of Akara. When you are analyzing Akara, Nama is Satya, but Nama is not really Satya. Here, to drive home the point, some example is, comparison is given here. Yatha, punyadikyat, manushya apekshya. अधिक काल स्थायी देव अमर इति उपचारेण उच्यते. व्हेन यू से देवता दैट अमर अमर पुरुष अमर देवता अमर देव दैट अमरत्व इज आपेक्षिक कंपेयर टू ह्यूमन बीइंग्स दे लिव लॉन्गर देयर फॉर दे आर कॉल्ड एज अमर दे आर नॉट रियली अमर अदरवाइज एवरी वन वुड वॉन्ट टू बिकम अमर दैट एवरी वन इट्सेल्फ विल नॉट हैव मीनिंग देन बिकॉज इट विल नॉट बी नित्य. That itself tells you that it is not nitya. If devas are many, amaratvam cannot be nitya. But compared to manushya, devas are amara. That amara is upachara. Apekshika amaratvam, not really amara. Tatha eva ghatadi padarthanam akara apekshya. Ghatadi namnam adhika kalasthayitva namnam satyatvam upachara. It is an upachara. It is not idamittham. ओंकारस्य ब्रह्माभेदेन चिंतनम. नाउ दिस ओंकार यू हैव लैंडेड ऑन, सो यू हैव लैंडेड फ्रॉम दिस एंटायर प्रपंच टू नाम. ऑल नाम आर इंक्लूडेड इन ओंकार एंड देयर बाय ओंकार यू हैव रीच्ड. बट व्हाट अबाउट ओंकार एज ब्रह्म? ओंकारस्य ब्रह्माभेदेन चिंतनम. नाउ ओंकार शुड बी अंडरस्टूड एज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ब्रह्म. यथा सर्वस्वरूप ओंकार तथा सर्वस्वरूपम ब्रह्म. Also, tasmad omkara brahma rupa. Shruti says that here we see omkaram eva idam sarvam. Omkaram eva idam sarvam. Shruti vakya. Then sarvam khalvidam brahma. Shruti vakya. There cannot be two sarvas. When you say sarva, all that sarva is said to be omkara. So LHS is what? On left side you have a formula where everything is Omkara. On right hand side you have everything is Brahma. To take away everything, what remains? Omkara on the left side, Brahma on the other side. Therefore, Omkara is Brahma. Tasmad Omkara Brahma Rupa. Shruti cannot be contradictory. It is apparent contradiction. When Shruti says everything is Omkara, elsewhere Shruti says everything is Brahma.
Omkara.
If one is a dullard, one would ask, you know, why does Shruti say it differently? Tell me one thing, is it Omkara or Brahma? It is Omkara which is Brahma. There is Samanadikaran. Sarvam Brahma and Sarvam Omkara. Sarvam is in Samanadikaran with Omkara as well as Brahma. Therefore, Asmad Omkara Brahma Rupa. Athava Omkara Brahmana Vachakaha. Brahma Omkarasya Vachyam. Now, Omkara is the name for Brahma. And Brahma is the Vachya. Or Omkara. Because when you talk about Omkara, what are you really talking about? You are really talking about Ishvara, you are talking about Brahma. Whether Saguna or Nirguna, it's a name for Brahma. Vachya Vachya Kyor Abhedasti. And we have seen this Nama and Namni have no difference. So Vachya and Vachaka has no difference. Which is it has already been established. Tasmad Api Omkara Brahma Rupaha. So thereby also, either you take Shruti as basis or you have questions, then this is the answer to the question. Incha vicharimani yadaksharam brahmani adhyastam tasya brahmanisthanam bhavati. Moreover, what else can be inquired into? Vicharimani, once you do vichara, yadaksharam brahmani adhyastam. Yadaksharam brahmani adhyastam. That Brahma is called by this akshara, omkara. So Brahma is Satya. We already know Satyam Jnanam Anandam Brahma, Satyam Brahma. Then everything other than Brahma, if you think Omkara is different from Brahma, Akshara is different from Brahma, then there is Adhyasa of Akshara on Brahma. Therefore, Brahmani Adhyastam Yad Aksharam, Tasya Adhisthanam Kim? Obviously Brahma. Without Satya Adhisthana, you cannot have any Adhyasa. So Adhyasa also, Nama Adhyasa has been done, Akshara Adhyasa, Omkara Adhyasa is done on what? It is on Brahma itself. So Adhisthana is Brahma. Adhyastasya Swarupam Adhisthanatna Atirichyate. You have seen it many times now. Sarpa is Adhyasta on Rajju. Does Sarpa have its own Satta? No. sarpaha adhisthana, adhisthana being rajju. So sarpaha adhisthana rajju na atirichyate. Similarly here adhyastasya swarupam adhisthanam and therefore adhyastasya swarupam adhisthanat na atirichyate. What is the swarupa? Adhisthana itself. Where did the sarpa go, if you ask? What is sarpa? It is all Rajju. Where did it go? It came from Rajju. It went back to Rajju. Tasmadapi Omkara Brahma Eva. So many ways to see how Omkara is Brahma, how Nama is Omkara, how Rupa is Nama, how Sarva Prapancha is nothing but Rupa, therefore Nama, therefore Omkara, therefore Brahma. Tasmad Omkaram Brahma Rupeda Chintayet. This is the laya krama, jhana krama also. Thereby nirguna upasana is possible. Brahma swarupasya omkarasya atmanaha cha abheda. We landed on Brahma. What about atma? Because aikya jnana has to take place. Jhana leading to Brahma will not lead to moksha. Aikya jnana is abheda between Brahma and atma, pratyangatma, which is me. So here you will land on Parokshyam, because Brahma Rupena Chintaye Omkaram, and that Omkara is, you see, Sarva Prapancha is Omkara. Then the most that you reach is Sarvam Brahma. Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma Asti, not Asmi. Therefore, Paroksha is the resultant, not Aparoksha. Atmana Brahmanascha Pada Chatushtayadi Nirupanam. So Brahma has four padas. Atma also has four padas. These are discussed in Pandukya Upanishad. So therefore both of them have four quarters or four padas. Brahma Swarupam Omkaram Atmanaha Abhinnataya Chintayet. Am I still audible? I think there was a power cut.
Yes.
So Brahma Rupam Omkaram Atmanaha Abhinnataya Chintayet. So Chintana Krama has been mentioned now this in the last, concluding section of Dhyana or Chintana. One has to think this Brahma as myself. This is Ahangra. Really, finally, Ahangra is Sarvam Aham. In the last step, Brahma Aham. Tatahi Atmana Brahmanasa Mukhya Bheda Asti. This is the Mukhya Bheda. It is not Gauna. Atma is Brahma, Brahma is Atma. Where is it Gauna then? Whenever you look at Badasamanadikaran, in the case of Sarvam Brahma, Sarvam Aham. You cannot have Sarvam and Aham. When there is Aikya, in Samanadikaran also you have to see at analyze what kind of Samanadikaran. So sarvam nasti, aham eva asmi, sarvam nasti, brahma eva asti, there bada samanarika. But when the Shruti says that sarvam brahma, sarvam atma, and then finally says brahma atma, atma brahma, by saying tattvam asmi, or aham brahma asmi, there aham atma brahma, what kind of samanarika? That Brahma is the Mukhya Samanadikaranyam. It is not Bada Samanadikaranyam. Because in the case of Sarvam, look at this. When you take each and every component in Sarva, so you look at Karya is Karana. That is a Prakriya. Now when you look at every manifest Prapancha, that is what Sarvam means now. Sarvam, the way we understand what is Sarvam, everything that is manifest, what is not manifest, I am unable to do chintana as to what is this unmanifest sarvam. So if you consider sarvam, all vyakta prapancha, sarvam vyakta prapancha, that is Brahma or Atma. Then all of that is Atma, all right? But is Atma all of that? Brahma all of that? Brahma is Ananta, whereas Sarva can have some quantification. When you quantify everything, this entire world, if I say this entire universe. But then there are so many universes possible. And even if we don't think that is possible, multiverses and things like that, but still, if you look at the ever-expanding universe also, there is, before the universe expanded, there is something outside, there is Astitvam. That Astitvam belongs to Brahma. So Brahma pervades this Prapancha, the universe, and is beyond. Dashangula. So it is Dashangula, everything plus Dashangula. Thereby everything is Brahma, but Brahma is not limited to everything. Purnameva avashishyate. Purnameva udichyate. So the Purnamada, Purnamidam, Purnat, Purnam udichyate. So that mantra, if you look at it, if you take away Purna from Purna, Purna remains. So that Purna, Brahma which is there, if you remove Sarva also, still Brahma Astitva is there. That Brahma is beyond the Sarva also. Thereby Sarva is Brahma, Brahma is not limited to Sarva. But if you look at Brahma and Atma, Aham Brahma, Brahma is Aham and Aham is also Brahma. So it works both ways. A equal to B, B is not equal to A in the earlier case. But here, in Aham Brahmasmi, A equal to B, B equal to A. They are interchangeable in totality. So Sarvam, you cannot say Sarvam is Karana. You can say Atma is Karana. Brahma is Karana for everything. You can say Atma is Karana for everything. But can you say Sarva is Karana for everything? Makes no sense. Sarva is everything. So they are not interchangeable. I mean, just for the sake of argument, even in thinking, if something is blocking, you can use anything. It may not be 100% accurate as what the Shruti, is expressing. The way the Shruti is expressing, it leaves scope for interpretation to reach the goal. As long as you land on the goal, there is a sthira buddhi, it is okay. So you can even see that. They are not interchangeable. Brahma and Atma are interchangeable. They work, the equation works both ways. This is one of the ways to see it. Not everyone agrees with it, but then that's the easy way out. Tathai Atmana Brahmana sa mukhya abheda asti, not gauna abheda, not upachara. It is not the way the earlier ways in upachara. It is not gauna, it is not upachara. It is not a stuti. It is not Arthavada and it is not through Lakshana also, because once you have landed on Brahma and Atma's real meaning, there is Mukhya Veda. In fact, there is no difference at all. There are no two entities and they work both ways. Brahmana Iva Atmanas Chatvaraha Padaha Santi Pado Nava Bhaga Aushava. So there are four Aushas, four Bhagas or four Padas. Four quarters, Virat, Hiranyagarbha, Ishwaraha. So Virat, Hiranyagarbha, Ishwara, Tatpada, Laksharta, Bhuta, Ishwara, Sakshi, Chaiti, Brahmana, Chatvaraha, Padaha. On the Samashti side, there is Virat, first Pada, Hiranyagarbha, second Pada, Sukshma, Virat is Stula, Stula, you know, Virat and Hiranyagarbha, Ishwara, Tatpada, Laksharta, Ishwara, Sakshi. So Ishwara, Sakshi is who? The Shuddha Chaitanya. Thereby there are four padas on the samashti. Brahma. Vishwa taijasa prajna tvampada lakshya jiva sakshi chaiti chatvara atmana padaha. On the atma side, vyakti side, there is Vishwa, taijasa and prajna, who are their respective avastha abhimani. Vishwa in jagrat avastha, taijasa in sukshma, which is swapna avastha, and prajna in the sushupti avastha. And then turiya is this Sakshi on both sides where there is no difference. Jiva Sakshi and Ishwara Sakshi cannot be really differentiated. Jiva Sakshina eva Turiya iti Vyapadesha. Jiva Sakshi is called as Turiya. Samashti Stula Prapancha Sahita Chaitanyasi Virad iti Nama. Vyashti Stula Abhimani Naha Vishwa iti Nama. So Samashti and Vyashti, Stula Sharira Abhimani have Virad and Vishwa as their respective names. Virajaha Vishwasya Sulo Upadikatvad Vishwa Virad Rupa Eva Natataha Anyaha. What is the meaning of Virat. Virat is the samashti stula sharira abhimani, jagrat avastha abhimani. Vishwa is samashti, vyashti stula sharira abhimani or jagrat avastha abhimani. Between them, what is the difference? Samashti and vyashti really. Stula upatikatvad vishwa virat rupa eva. Vishwa is nothing but Virat because of Stula Upadhi. Stula Upadhi is not different between the two. That is the definition. Stula Upadhi, Stula Sharira Abhimani. Thereby, Vishwa is nothing but Virat. Na tatha anyaha. That is why Bhagavan Bhashyakara, while analyzing in Mandukya Upanishad, while there is a talk going on Vishwa, suddenly he talks about Virat. Then there is a Puropaksha as to analysis on Vyashti level. Why do you reach Samashti? How did you make this Herculean jump? What kind of a jump is this? We are talking about an individual. Suddenly you have landed on Virat. How does that work? So Bhagavan Bhashyakara brings in the, I think, Grahadaranyaka quotation there, mantra. So there is a section where Yajnavalkya is approached by some upasakas and they are doing upasana as, one part of some upasana is mentioned of samashti, but then one part is taken and one is doing one part upasana on one part, the other is doing another part, third is doing another part. So some example is given. So upasakas are doing upasana on bhaga, not on in entirety. And there Yajnavalkya says, it is good that you came to me. Had you continued this, this is not the way to do upasana, your head would have fallen off. So there is a Virat upasana where he says that this Virat, what you are doing there, your head would have fallen off. So why will the Vyashti head fall off when the Samashti is not processed properly? Assembled properly, so to say, in upasana, because of abheda. So he brings in that to establish that there is no bheda between Vishwa and Virat, because one who is doing upasana, even the Akshi Purusha, when you are doing it, it is the entire Virat who is me. In Ahangra upasana, it is not one part of me and one part of Ishwara, one part. The upasana is in its entirety. There is no bheda at all. So there, as a as an Arthavada, it may be saying that you're good, you came to me, otherwise your head would have, why would a Vyashti head fall off? Because Vyashti is non-different from Samashti. Samashti is seen limited, for example, let's say Samashti is seen as without the head. Meaning you are doing dhyana on the trunk, but you miss the head. Meaning you are headless. Your head will fall off. That is the Arthavada there, but expression is used only to drive home the point that there is aikya between the samashti and vyashti. There is no difference at all. Abheda. That is said here. Viraja vishvasya stula upadikatvad vishva virad rupa eva. Na tata anyaha. There is aikya at the samashti and vyashti level. Between samashti and vyashti at all levels. Sukshma, stula or at the even the karana level. At the avidya and maya level. So anyway, we'll pause here. We'll continue in the next part. Sukannityam saprakasham vyapakan namurupya adhisthanam buddhya buddhyam buddhyer aparam sarvyadanta vidyam pratyak paramah tadeva annavattvanirthi. Just to mention here the chintana krama is explained, and as it was mentioned earlier, chintana one can do, to understand and land on the jnana, but jnana one should not do unless one is a sannyasi. That is the idea which was mentioned there. That is why he is analyzing in detail, so that we get the jnana as how this aikya works, how abheda works. We need not do dhyana, we don't have adhikara also, and we need not do it because jnana is an easier way out.